Welcome back to my channel, this is Warik TV 2.0.
Flash report, Larry King, the radio and television personality, whose breezy and at times conversational interviews with celebrities and world leaders made him a broadcasting icon for nearly half a century, has died, his TV production company Aura Media said in a statement on Saturday. He was 87. The statement said he had been receiving treatment at the Cedars-Sinai Medical Center in Los Angeles. It did not specify the cause of death, but King was recently hospitalized with pandemic disease and had endured health problems for many years, including a near-fatal stroke in 2019 and diabetes. Whether he was interviewing a U.S. president, foreign leader, celebrity, scandal-ridden personage or an everyman, Larry liked to ask short, direct and uncomplicated questions, it added. Paying tribute to King in a statement, CNN President Jeff Zucker said that the scrappy young man from Brooklyn had a history-making career due to his generosity of spirit that drew the world to him. Over a nearly 60-year career that spanned radio, cable television and the internet, the Brooklyn native estimated that he conducted more than 50,000 interviews, not one of which he prepared for in advance. But that of the talk style, along with his raspy baritone delivery and trademark suspenders, made Larry King live a popular primetime draw on CNN from 1985 through 2010. It was a run that helped build the cable news network into a major presence in American living rooms. Even though he wouldn't meticulously prepare for interviews like the famed television journalist Barbara Walters, the rich and famous clearly were comfortable answering his questions. The actor Marlon Brando, a legendary recluse, gave a rare interview to King in 1994 because he said the host was unexploitative. There was a sense that his interviews were like conversations that could be had over a plate of meatloaf. Robert Thompson, director of the Blyer Center for Television and Popular Culture at Syracuse University, told NBC News. That type of approach occasionally became a recipe for disaster, such as the 2007 interview with Jerry Seinfeld, who took King to task for not knowing that he, not the network, ended his famous sitcom, Seinfeld, after a highly rated 9-year run. "I thought it was pretty well documented," Seinfeld answered. "Isn't this CNN?" King later admitted he should have known that a show which boasted a viewership of 75 million for its finale wouldn't have been cancelled. It wasn't all fluff, though. On November 10, 1993, King used his show to host a debate between Vice President Al Gore and billionaire businessman Ross Perot on the proposed North American Free Trade Agreement that helped keep public support for the treaty. Born to Jewish immigrant parents, on November 19, 1933, Lawrence Harvey Zeidler took his New York accent and delivery with him to Miami, where he started his on-air career as a disc jockey in 1957 after changing his last name to King. Over the next decade, the fledgling journalist would hone his interviewing style in Florida, first with a live show broadcast from a restaurant and later as a columnist for the Miami Herald. Then in December 1971, his promising career in Miami derailed with an arrest on a grand larceny charge over $5,000 he allegedly owed a financier. That led to a 6-year exile, during which time King did publicity for a racetrack in Louisiana. But King would eventually return to Miami and to a microphone. In 1978, The Larry King Show became a nationally syndicated staple in 28 cities. Within 5 years, it would be broadcast in 118 markets, according to CNN. King also went national in his side gig as a newspaper columnist, debuting his USA Today column in 1982. 3 years later, on June 3, 1985, Larry King Live premiered on CNN, beginning the 25-year run that would make him an even bigger household name. At the time, the cable news network was still struggling to fill airtime, and it would be decades before competition from MSNBC and Fox News forced more dynamic programming choices. In 1989, King was inducted into the Radio Hall of Fame. By the time he ended his run on CNN, Larry King Live was entrenched in the Guinness Book of World Records as the longest-running show with the same host in the same time slot. That retirement proved short-lived. In 2012, King launched a new show, Larry King Now, with the web-based Aura TV. The next year, another King-hosted show, Politikum, debuted on the Russian TV network, RT. I thought I could live, King told the Today Show in 2013. I thought it would be easy, but the night Osama bin Laden was killed, I just wanted to jump up off the chair and run and do something. In 2017, Terry Richard, ex-wife to late entertainer Eddie Fisher, accused King of groping her on two separate occasions in the 2000s. He denied the allegations that were printed by the British Daily Mail. Over the years, King survived multiple heart attacks. He had quintuple bypass surgery in 1987 that led him to quit smoking. The surgery also inspired him to establish a charity, the Larry King Cardiac Foundation, that helped fund medical treatment for vulnerable patients who didn't have insurance. He married his seventh wife, Sean Southwark, at UCLA Medical Center just before undergoing cardiac surgery in 1997, according to CNN. In August 2019, however, he filed for divorce from her after 22 years of marriage. That year, he told The Extra Show that he had suffered a stroke that put him in a coma for a couple weeks. "It's been a rough year," he said. In 2020, his 65-year-old son, Andy, died of a heart attack and his 50-year-old daughter, Chaya, died of lung cancer. He is survived by three other biological children. He lived long enough that he was a force to be recognized in the network era, the cable era and the internet era, Syracuse University's Thompson said, and that's pretty impressive. Funeral schedule soon will be announced, family statement said.
Hi guys, I am Zai, and this is Warik TV 2.0 channel. Kung bago lang po kayo sa channel ko, huwag mahiyang mag-subscribe. Thank you.
Warik TV 2.0.
Disclaimer: some images and video clips that I used this vlog are not mine, for educational purposes only. Thank you.